Good morning, everybody. Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande. We are in the Ayurveda College, Nigri, Pradhikaran, Pune 44. With me are postgraduate students of Ayurveda. And today, on Tuesday, that is 3rd of July 2018, I would like to discuss with these my students the gynecological problems in general practice. Gynecological problems in GP. GP means general medical practice. But today we will try to focus three or four important gynecological problems, their causes, and the allopathic treatment for those diseases. We are going to conduct another lesson for the Ayurvedic management, but today we have the focus on the modern or the allopathic treatment for these gynecological problems. So the three important problems that today we are going to discuss. Number one, delayed menarche. This is the first problem that we are going to discuss. Second, abnormal and excessive uterine bleeding. And third problem is dysmenorrhea, painful menstruation. So we will start one by one. The first problem is delayed menarche. In the last lecture, when we were studying about the female reproductive cycle or the menstrual cycle, just yesterday we have talked about that, and we have seen that the female, the ladies, the girl, they start their menstruation around the age of 13, 14, 15, 16, etc. And when the menstrual cycle starts or the begins in the life, that is called as a menarche. And when that cycle ends at the around age of 50 years, that is called as a menopause. Today we are concentrating on the menarche, because many parents are worried if the girl is not getting the menses in the expected period, because they 100% know that this character of menstrual cycle is very much important to make a girl into the female or a feminine characters. That means then she is proved to be the having the power of reproduction. And that's why before marriage, always all the parents, they are worried about whether the girl is getting the starting of the menses at a proper time or not. So ideally, the doctor should convince as a family physician to the parents that wait till the age of 16 years minimum. Don't make a hurry. If the girl is of 14 years, 13 years, and if she is not getting the menses, is not at all a problem. So the parents should wait, or the girl should wait minimum at the age of 16 years. But further extension, you must remember, some girls, they may delay the menses till 18 years. So, minimum 16 years and maximum 18 years. If at all, at the age of 18 years also, she has a birthday of 18 years completed and still she has not getting any menstruation, then that is a problem of worry. Then the doctor should take an aggressive management, try to make a difference. Before 18 years, you can counseling, you can do the counseling, you can do the supportive medicines, you can do the general physical checkup. But that doesn't mean you should start a hormonal complicated treatments. You understand? Actually, aggressive treatment should be started only and only after if the girl has not received the menses after the age of 18 years. So maximum what is the age to wait for is 18 years. Remember. Now, after the 18 years, we have to decide, we have to diagnose the case, what may be the causes. So, there are basically two types of variations. One is a primary amenorrhea with secondary sex characters not developed. So, you have to see, you have to check the girl. She has amenorrhea, that is primary amenorrhea, and she has also not developed secondary sex characters. In Ayurveda, it is called as a Jata Vyanjana Lakshane. which we have already discussed. There is a deposition of fat, development of pelvic region, development of the breast, appearance of the pubic hairs, axillary hairs, voice is changed, attraction towards the opposite sex. All these are called as a secondary sex characters. So the girl is having the amenorrhea, no menses, and also secondary sex characters are not developed. Now till now you have learned which hormone is responsible for developing secondary sex characters. That is definitely estrogen. Try to understand. And estrogen is stimulated by FSH, because when ovary starts functioning. So the basic understanding should be when secondary sex characters are not there and period is not there. So the problem should be endocrinal. What should be your diagnosis? Either the problem is a endocrinal or developmental problem due to endocrine system. So better family physician can refer these cases to the endocrinologist. I repeat, primary amenorrhea with secondary sex characters not developed. This is not the case of family physician, because the problem may be endocrinal and you should refer the cases to the endocrinologist. Now the second category, what is that? There is a primary amenorrhea, that means no menses, but the girl has developed secondary sex characters. The girl has developed secondary sex characters. Breast development is there, axillary hair are there, voice change is there, attraction towards the opposite sex, fat deposition, height and weight has been increased, everything. As a puberty, all changes are there. But only the problem is menses has not started. Now this group is under the control of family physician. Then you must make a three category of this group, three compartments. The first, you have to observe the external stature of the girl, whether the girl is having the normal build. First category, girl with normal build, height, weight is normal. Second category, obese girl. And third category, thin girl, weight is less. So I repeat, we are talking about the family physician cases where the girl is having secondary sex characters but menses has not started. We have to categorize the girl in three groups. Some girls will be normal built, height and weight normal, looking normal. You will see some girls are looking obese. They are obese 100% by looking, by taking the weight, by taking their body mass index, BMI. And it is confirmed, this is obesity. And third category is less weight than the expectation, than the age, than the height. The weight is less. Now, in all these three groups, causes are different. Causes will be different for the primary amenorrhea. Number one, if the girl is normal built, secondary sex characters are there. Here the causes may be imperforate hymen. Imperforate hymen. So everything is normal, only the menstrual blood is not coming out. It is stagnated because of the imperforate hymen. Second, absent or underdeveloped uterus. Absent or underdeveloped uterus. So these are the causes for the normal built girl. Now what are the investigations? Ultrasonography. The commonest investigation is USG of abdomen and pelvis. If uterus is underdeveloped, hormonal treatment is essential to stimulate. Hormonal treatment is essential. The commonest tablets are a combination of estrogen and progesterone. And the famous is Overall, O-V-R-A-L, tablet Overall, one at night for 21 days. Then stop. See whether the withdrawal bleeding is there. Again, If not second, after the 8 days gap, again start the second course. So you can try for 3 cycles. Hormonal treatment of overall, OVRL, tablet overall, 1 HS means 1 at night with little bit milk. Because many contraceptive, many hormonal pills, they cause gastritis. This is the commonest side effect. So either you can prescribe some antacid. For example, Histac tablet. H-I-S-T-A-C. Histac means ranitidine. So this tablet can be given with overall to prevent the gastritis due to the hormonal tablet. Or carrier should be the milk. Ayurvedic language it is called anupan. Now, you are giving the hormonal treatment for underdeveloped uterus for 3 cycles, for 3 months. Still, if it is not getting any results, then again it is your duty to refer the case to the gynecologist or the endocrinologist. Duty of a family physician, do not try more than 3 cycles. Never try more than 3 cycles. Another cause, what we have seen? Imperforate hymen. These cases should be referred to the surgeon, again gynecologist, surgeon, to do the appropriate surgery for imperforate hymen. Now we will talk about second group. Primary amenorrhea, secondary sex characters are there, but obesity is there. The girl is overweight 100%. Then what may be the causes? First we have to diagnose. Number one, simple thing you can do always, ultrasonography, USG. There you can rule out PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease. It is also called as a PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Then in sonography you may see adrenogenital tumor. Adrenogenital tumor. This may be the cause in obesity. And third cause for the amenorrhea is hypothyroidism. Hypo, that is myxedema. So you have to see the T3, T4 levels. They will be definitely less than the normal. Thyroid hormones will be less in the body. That is called as hypothyroidism. In obese girl, all these investigations are must. And if particular reason is found, you have to treat according to the cause. If PCOS, treat PCOS. Adrenogenital tumor, try further management of any tumor. Then if it is a case of hypothyroidism, treat with tablet Altroxin. Okay. Now, the basic advice should be given to this girl, reduce the weight. First thing to start the menses, she must take precaution of reducing the weight. And simultaneously, again, you can try the same hormonal prescription. That is tablet overall. Same. I am purposefully giving only one tablet for easy remembrance. In the market, there are 100 tablets. 100 tablets. But to begin with, family physician must know at least one tablet which he 100% can start. So for everything, for the normal build, for low obese, you must give the overall tablet, one at night with milk or with tablet ranitidine, which is antacid, for 3 cycles. Always make a rule, for gynecological treatment, every treatment should be tried maximum for 3 cycles, according to the modern science. Okay. Now, we will talk about the third group. The girl having the amenorrhea, secondary sex characters are there, but the girl is having low weight than the expected weight. As per the height, as per the age, weight is less. Girl is looking thin, skinny. Then what can be the probable causes? First, you have to check about the hyperthyroidism. In hyperthyroidism, there is always weight loss. Ask for T3, T4 thyroid hormones, they will be on the higher side. They will be on the higher side, T3, T4, thyroxin. So that is a case of hyperthyroidism. Chest X-ray is must. Chest X-ray to rule out the tuberculosis infection, because tuberculosis also can cause weight loss. Then again the same, if the cause is found, first you have to treat the cause, automatically amenorrhea will go. But simultaneously, if these causes are not there, then again you can try for same tablet. Tablet overall, 1 HS for 3 cycles. But for the thin girl, you must advise about the diet and lifestyle to build up her general health. As we have talked about obesity, what is the duty of feminine physician? To reduce the weight. Here the girl is thin, so she must take a balanced, freshly cooked and wholesome diet. High protein diet, high calorie diet is a must for thin girl. But obesity, this is contraindicated. So you have to treat according to the cases. So this is all about the primary amenorrhea cases. So we are talking only at the level of general medical practice. We are not talking about the bookish total textual picture. But amenorrhea patient can come to you either with the secondary sex characters or without secondary sex characters. Without secondary sex characters, the problem is endocrinal, refer to the endocrinologist. And another case, there are three groups: normal built, thin girl and obese girl. After this amenorrhea, totally opposite we will talk. During the period of 20 to 40 years of age, if the girl or rather lady is coming to you that she is having the problem with the menses, and what are the problems? She is getting a lot and lot of bleeding. Every time she is having a lot of bleeding. So second problem in medical general practice, gynecological problem, is abnormal and excessive uterine bleeding. Abnormal and excessive uterine bleeding. Here, there are four important types. Excessive bleeding, four important types. First type, the title is menorrhagia. M-E-N-O-R-R-H-A-G-I. Menorrhagia. Number two, polymenorrhea. P-O-L-Y. M-E-N-O-R-R-H-O-E-A. There is not H. First, menorrhagia. Here, polymenorrhea. Third one, the combination of above two. Polymenorrhagia. Spelling is different, pronunciation is different, and the conditions are different. Try to understand. Looking like very similar, but there is a subtle difference. You must understand these phrases separately. In our mind, we have always one concept: heavy menstruation. DUB, dysfunctional uterine bleeding. But no students are able to classify this excessive bleeding. So my dear students, you must classify as a menorrhagia, polymenorrhagia, and last one, fourth one, metrorrhagia. There is T, M-E-T-R-O-R-R-H-A-G-I, metrorrhagia. These are the four conditions regarding the excessive menstrual cycle. Now we will discuss one by one. Number one, what is menorrhagia? Usually the cycle is of 28 days and bleeding is for 4 days. So 4 by 28 is a normal. Am I right? 4 by 28. This is normal pattern. In menorrhagia, 28 days remain the same, but amount or duration increases. That means in spite of 4 days, the bleeding may be 7 or 8 days. So the formula will be 8 by 28. What is menorrhagia? 8 by 28. Cycle is coming every after 28 days. But when the menses starts, it is continued. After 4 days, it may be 6 days, 8 days, 10 days. That is called as the menorrhagia. And even if it is 4 days, usually the girl take 2 or 3 maximum pads in 24 hours. But if the lady has to take 6-7 pairs per 24 hours. That is also called as a menorrhagia. Remember, either the duration is increasing or amount is increasing. Amount is increased. That is called as a menorrhagia. Now what is next? Polymenorrhea. Here, bleeding is for 4 days. Only with the 2-3 pairs per day. But that cycle is coming very frequently. In spite of 28, it may be coming after 20 days. Every after 20 days. Every after 15 days. So the formula will be 4 by 15 or 4 by 20. Are you getting? The frequency of cycle is fast. Duration is okay. Amount is okay. But in spite of 28 days, again and again, again and again it is coming. Cycle is fast. Third category. It's a combination of two. Periods are coming frequently and the amount or the duration is also long. So again we can write down the formula. 9 by 20. Bleeding is for 9 days. Just 10 days break, again starts. So cycle is frequent, also the duration is more. So that is a combination of menorrhagia and polymenorrhea. So that is called as a polymenorrhagia. And fourth type is everything is disturbed. No rule, no regulation. Cyclicity lost. Sometimes early, sometimes late. Cyclicity lost. Sometimes early, sometimes late. Amount variable. Sometimes less, sometimes more. In Ayurveda, it is always called as a feature of Vata Dosha. Ayurveda always explains Vata is irregularity. Am I right? Vishamata. Or imbalance, irregular. That is, everything is metrorrhagia. Amount, sometimes less, sometimes more. No rule. No rule, no regulation. And that is why this is a fourth category of excessive bleeding. So I repeat the four names. First is menorrhagia. Then second, polymenorrhea. Third, polymenorrhagia. And fourth, metrorrhagia. So you may ask, sir, why in detail we have to know all these terms? Excess is excess. No. We can diagnose the case clinically in a different way. Let us see the causes. Causes are different for each thing. Write down the causes. First, menorrhagia. Causes are mainly in the uterus. So it may be the uterine fibroid, or adenomyosis. For the menorrhagia, the cause is in uterus, you must remember. And this is a excessive bleeding for 8 days and it's very tiresome. It causes a lot and lot of weakness. So the lady, first demand of the lady is, please stop my bleeding. Please control my bleeding. It is irritating to me. I cannot bear this type of bleeding. So there must be hemostatic treatment to stop the blood, to control the blood. So hemostatic treatment is the principle. This is called as a first aid management, casualty management, emergency management. Which are the drugs? Number one. Tablet Gynec CVP, G-Y-N-A-E-C, Gynec CVP, this is the name of the tablet, one morning, one afternoon, one in the evening, one TDS, tablet Gynec CVP, or there is option, tablet Stadren, S-T-A-D-R-E-N, tablet Stadren CKP, Stadren CKP, two tablets three times in a day. Two morning, two afternoon, two evening. I repeat the names: Gynec CVP, 1 TDS, Statren CKP. There is difference of Gynec CVP and Statren CKP. These are the brand names. This is 2 TDS. But if bleeding is very, very severe, then in spite of oral drugs, you can give injection. And what is the name of the injection? Injection Styptochrome. 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 Injection Styptochrome 2 ml stat. When she comes into your clinic, give 2 ml intramuscular injection Styptochrome. Most of the times the bleeding is always with the spasm or the dysmenorrhea is there. Pains are there. Then you have to add another tablet, that is Meftal Spas. Tablet Meftal, M-E-F-T-A-L, Meftal Spas, 500 mg TDS. Meftal Spas, 500 mg TDS. I repeat the three names of the tablets: Gynec CVP 1 TDS, Statren CKP 2 TDS. This is or. But this Meftal Spas is common for both, 500 mg TDS. Meftal Spas contains mefenamic acid. Okay. Now, with this acute management, you have also to start some hormonal treatment, like as usual. It is called as a resetting of hormonal cycle. Always the modern gynecologist or modern gynecological problems are treated with a combination of estrogen and progesterone. It is like a shock treatment, again giving a boost of hormones, so automatically inner body cycle will continue. The same drug I am using, tablet overall, the same tablet, 1 HS from 5th day of the menses or whatever, whenever it stops. After stopping the menses, you start this overall for the 21 days. For the 21 days. Again, what is the rule, thumb rule for the gynec problems? Hormonal treatment should be given for 3 maximum cycles by the family physician. If within 3 cycles he don't get any response, better refer to the endocrinologist or gynecologist. I think this rule should be continuous in our mind. But in between, you can check this patient for another investigations. Which are the investigations for menorrhagia? Number one, ultrasonography to detect the fibroid or structural defect in the uterus. Structural defect like bicornuate uterus, bicornuate, bicornuate uterus. Then if it is structural problem is found, it has to be corrected by surgery. Fibroid, fibroidectomy. You have to remove the fibroid. Okay. Then you can do the T3, T4 again. Because in both the cases, either of hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism, you can get the heavy menstruation. But the most probably is in hyperthyroidism, you will get the more bleeding. So T3, T4 levels will be high. Third thing, to detect any bleeding disorder, to detect any bleeding, because this is a problem of blood. So you must perform the hemogram and ESR. Hemogram and ESR. For example, in hemogram you will get the hemoglobin. Patient may be anemic. So anemia may be the cause of heavy bleeding, or due to the heavy bleeding there may be anemia. So it's like a vicious cycle. It's like a vicious cycle. So if you find that the lady has a hemoglobin low, that is below the 10 gram, you also treat by iron supplement. Like for example, capsule Autrin, A-U-T-R-I-N. One capsule BD, for anemia, capsule or trin, A-U-T-R-I-N. Then you can see whether there is any infection, leukocytosis. Then also you must advise or look for platelet count. You can check platelet counts. What is the disease with the low platelet count? What is the name for that disease? ITP, idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. Idiopathic thrombocytopenic purpura. This may be the cause for the bleeding. Then you must do the bleeding time and clotting time. Bleeding time and clotting time. So you can detect any blood discrasias. It is called as a blood discrasias, D-Y-S-C-R-I-S. That means the bleeding disorders. So for the menorrhagia, you can do all this type of investigation. And if at all everything is normal, the last, but it should be avoided as far as possible, that is called as a therapeutic or diagnostic, rather diagnostic, D and C. You know this term, D and C. Dilatation and curettage. D and C, to detect the cause of the menorrhagia. So in menorrhagia, the cause is in uterus. Now we will talk the second problem, that is polymenorrhea. Polymenorrhea, when the cycle is coming very frequently. First, the cause was in uterus. Now for polymenorrhea, cause is in the ovaries. For polymenorrhea, cause is mostly in the ovaries. And what can be the causes around the ovary? Number one, congestion. Regarding the ovary, congestion, infection, and third, endometriosis. Endometriosis, E-N-D-O-M-E-T-R-I-O-S-I-S, endometriosis. So these are the causes for polymenorrhea. Of course, physiological reasons you also must remember. Some physiological situations are there when there is a repeated cycles are coming. One is after menarche. When the menarche starts after puberty, first few cycles are little bit faster. So that is physiological, after menarche. Then before coming the menopause, there can be a little bit variation, fast cycles every after 20 days, possibility. And third, after pregnancy, when the first cycle starts, again for few months the cycles will be fast. So these are the three conditions, menarche, menopause and pregnancy, where there may be little bit faster cycles, frequency will be little bit faster. Now, so in these three cases, the hormonal treatment is not necessary. Okay? And for other cases, as I have told you, always the, like a menorrhagia, you have to give the hormonal treatment with overall. Again, the same thing. They just push or reset the natural cycle by giving the external supplement of the oral tablet, that is estrogen and progesterone. Now we will discuss about the third case, third group, polymenorrhagia. Combination of above two. So what are the causes? First cause is PID, pelvic inflammatory disease. So it will affect the uterus as well as it will affect the ovary. First cause was about the uterus, menorrhagia, polymenorrhea with the ovary, and this now polymenorrhagia with the uterus, with the ovary, like a pelvic region, pelvic inflammatory disease, PID. Then disturbance in the hypothalamus pituitary ovarian axis. You remember this stimulation. Hypothalamus gives the stimulation to the pituitary gland. pituitary gland gives the stimulation to the ovary. So in this signaling, there may be some problem. That is called as HPO axis. Hypothalamus, pituitary, ovary axis. Here also you have to do the USG, ultrasonography. If it is a PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, the treatment will be different. Like you have to give the higher antibiotic, like tablet ciprofloxacin, Ciprox, 500 milligram BD, ciprofloxacin or Ciprox. Then for anaerobic infection, which is the drug? Metronidazole, that is Metrogyl. Metrogyl tablet 400 milligram TDS and tablet Doxy, DOXY, Doxy 1, it is called as Doxy 1, DOXY 1 number, which contains 100 milligram doxycycline. That tablet for BD. So I repeat, there are three tablets for the PID. Pelvic inflammatory disease should be treated by antibiotics. One is the Ciprox, 500 milligram BD, tablet Metrogyl, 400 milligram TDS, and tablet Doxy 1, 100 milligram BD. All the treatment should be given for minimum 7 days. Then only that infection will go. And if PID is not the cause, what is the usual management? Stimulate the hormones by giving the tablet overall at 1 HS for 3 cycles. Now the fourth cause of the excessive menstruation is metrorrhagia. Everything is irregular. And cause is surface lesion of genital tract. Surface lesion of genital tract from vulva to endometrium. Surface lesion, word is different. From vulva to endometrium, anywhere there may be some problem. So can you understand the four conditions differently? Menorrhagia, problem was uterus. Polymenorrhea, problem was in the ovary. Polymenorrhagia, problem near the uterus, near the ovary, that is pelvic region, that is PID. And now metrorrhagia, problem is at the level of surface. I will give the examples. So here you have to do the per vaginal examination, PV. PV is must to find out local lesion at vulva. For example, vulvitis, any abscess, any ulcer, look for vagina, vaginitis, cervix, cervicitis, cervical erosion. These are called as a surface lesion, either ulcer or inflammation. Where? In the vagina, in the vulva, in the cervix, or in the uterus. Ulcer or inflammation, that is called as a surface lesion. Of course, what you have to do? Treat the local cause, whichever the cause you have found. If cervical erosion is there, you can do the cautery for the cervical erosion. If there is a cervicitis, if there is a vaginitis, give the antibiotics. Simple thing. Then you can also do the ultrasonography. And if the ultrasonography, by chance, if you find there is a PCOD, treat PCOD. Ectopic gestation, by chance amenorrhea is there and ectopic gestation, then there may be heavy bleeding. And sometimes abortion has been already taken, threatened abortion or incomplete abortion, then there will be also picture like metrorrhagia. Incomplete abortion, that means conception products remained in the uterus, like placenta, some pieces of the placenta are already there in the uterus. So that can also cause the heavy, irregular type of the bleeding. That is also like a metrorrhagia. You understand? So USG is also must for metrorrhagia. Now, you have already understood the four factors of heavy menstruation, but some specific, very peculiar instruction for the physician. Number one, whenever there is excessive bleeding, first your effort should be find out the cause. Ayurveda has also given the emphasis. Without cause, don't treat it. Because you know, I have to give the hemostatic, symptomatic, and I have to give the overall. No, that is absolutely wrong. First, your diagnosis should be 100% sure, and then only you treat the case. That is very important. Number two, no shooting in dark. The same line I have transported in another language. No, this is English language. No shooting in dark. That means blank darkness is there. That is called as a shooting in dark. That means giving the haphazard treatment without underlying, without knowing the cause behind that. Just diagnose as a Rakta Pradara in Ayurveda, excessive bleeding, and give the treatment. That is a wrong policy. You are not a correct ideal doctor. Try to understand. This is very, very serious. Bleeding is not a simple thing. So you must not go the haphazard treatment. Number three, if the patient is at very young age, there may be some psychological stress, and that must be found out. The lady must have some family problems, or the love affairs are there, breakups are there, and lot of stress can be there. That is called as the functional causes. But that functional causes should not be taken into granted. No, this bleeding is psychological. No, this is wrong. First investigate. If all investigations are normal, like your hemogram, then what platelet count, BTCT count, thyroid function test, USG, everything is absolutely normal, then only you can think of that. It may be the psychological. Same is the case with about the senior citizens, like middle ages, that 40 years of the lady may have another problems. Like the her son has gone to the America, there is no, she is lonely, husband is busy with his business, and the lady is feeling alone. That may be again psychological cause. But there also, you must taken into granted. First, physical causes should be ruled out, and last will be the psychological reason. That is, psychological point is called as a functional. Remember the organic and functional. These words you must remember. When the lady is of 25 to 30, always ask about the menstrual history. And after a period of loss of menses or the amenorrhea, if she is getting problem, that problem cannot be can be pregnancy related problem, as we already discussed. There may be pregnancy related problem. It may be case of miscarriage. It may be the case of incomplete or threatened abortion. So it is not a only menstrual cycle problem. It may be the pregnancy related problems that you must check out. So, after the menopause, if at all any sort of bleeding is there, especially if it is brown color, if it is offensive, then very, very dangerous. After menopause bleeding is suggestive of cancer. Never forget. After menopause, if at all any bleeding, that means if the lady has stopped the bleeding or menopause has occurred 1 year back and now she has again started the bleeding, it's very dangerous. It can be the case of cancer, malignancy. So post-menopausal bleeding, rule out malignancy. Post-menopausal bleeding, rule out malignancy. Another thing, more the irregular bleeding, there is more need of investigation. Try to understand. More the irregularity, more you must check the investigation or do some curettage. So this is the end of our second topic. First we discussed about amenorrhea. Second we discussed about heavy menstruation. And last small topic I will take, that is dysmenorrhea. In Ayurveda also it is mentioned, kashtartava. Amenorrhea in Ayurveda it is called as anartava. Anartava. then this heavy bleeding, it is called as a Rakta Pradara in Ayurveda. Rakta Pradara. And now dysmenorrhea is a Kashta Artava. Kashta means painful bleeding. There are mainly two or three types. Number one, true or spasmodic dysmenorrhea. True, T-R-U-E, or spasmodic dysmenorrhea. Number two, congestive dysmenorrhea. Congestive dysmenorrhea. And last, third one, pain with endometriosis. That means pregnancy has occurred outside the uterus. That is called as a endometriosis. That is, pregnant product are situated outside the uterus. That is called as endometriosis. So primary or the true dysmenorrhea, second is a congestive, and last is endometriosis. First, true or spasmodic dysmenorrhea, again the cause is uterus, pains arising from uterus, which is more or times physiological, which is called as a first day pain. First day pain. It may start 1 day or 2 days before. It may start 1 or 2 days before and occurs during the age 15 to 18. Menarche starts, and first 3-4 years the lady, the girl can get this true type of the spasmodic type of the dysmenorrhea. Yesterday we have talked about that prostaglandin that causes the spasm in the uterus during the bleeding, and that is the normal. So this particular true or spasmodic dysmenorrhea can be cured after pregnancy, can be cured automatically after pregnancy. Till then you can treat symptomatically. You can treat the symptomatic treatment, anti-inflammatory drug like Meftal-Spas. Okay, so true dysmenorrhea can be treated with NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. One is the famous product is Meftal-Spas, which contains mefenamic acid and diacyclomine, like Voveron. Diacyclomine is content of Voveron. So it's a combination of mefenamic acid and diacyclomine, that is Meftal-Spas, 1 TDS with milk. If no relief, again the same tablet overall, 1 OD from 5th to 25th day, from 5th to 25th day of menses, which can suppress the ovulation, which can suppress the ovulation, and pain can be reduced. Pain can be reduced. Now, when this true dysmenorrhea, first day pain, is only on one side, is only on the one, right or left side, unilateral, then you must do the ultrasonography. Ultrasonography to check out, to rule out uterine malformation. Uterine malformation. If your hormonal treatment is not working, then you can do the advice for dilatation of cervix. Dilatation of cervix or paracervical block. Paracervical block. So we have talked about the first type, that is true spasmodic dysmenorrhea. Now I am going for second type, congestive dysmenorrhea. Congestive dysmenorrhea. This pain starts minimum 3 to 4 days before menses. Before 3 to 4 days before menses, and automatically reduces with the menstrual flow. That means first day there is some bleeding, second day there is bleeding, then automatically that pain will go, because it is occurring because of the heavy blood supply to the uterine part. That is, you know that it is called as a proliferative phase. So that is called as a congestive dysmenorrhea. The blood is already stagnant over there. But here also you can do the sonography to rule out other causes like PID, pelvic inflammatory disease, PID, or myomatas, some muscular growth is there, myomatas, M-Y-O-M-A-T-S. Of course, myomatas is a surgical condition, you have to refer to the surgeon. PID, you have to treat with antibiotics. Then, for congestive treatment, PID, I have already given you the antibiotics. But again, the same, you have to stimulate the hormonal cycle with tablet overall G. One tablet at night from 5th to 25th day. In congestive dysmenorrhea, there is a pain even at the pelvic region or the backache. So low backache, dull pelvic pain is another characteristic of the congestive dysmenorrhea. Low backache, pelvic pain. This is another feature than the first one. In the first true dysmenorrhea, there is only first day pain. Here the pain has started from the 4 days before and it is a backache also there because of the congestion. Now the last condition is a endometriosis. Endometriosis. Here the pain feature is very different, very interesting. Pain starts 3 days before the menses. Pain starts 3 days before the menses, but it gradually increasing, first day, second day, third day, the pain is increasing, not relieving. And at the end of menses, there is extreme pain, very high point pain. So do you understand the difference? It is not reducing, rather it is increasing. Rather, it is increasing in endometriosis. So immediately you have to advise for ultrasonography. Then you can try for hormonal treatment like tablet regesterone. The tablet is different. R-E-G-E-S-T-E-R-O-N-E. Tablet regesterone, 5 milligram from 5th to 25th day for 3 cycles. Tablet regesterone, R-E-G-E-S-T-E-R-O-N-E, 5 milligram from 5th to 25th day for 3 cycles. Of course, if no response, you must refer these cases to the gynecologist. So, my dear friends, today on Tuesday, that is 3rd of July 2018, I have discussed gynecological problems in medical general practice, that is GP. 3 problems we discussed: amenorrhea, excessive bleeding, and dysmenorrhea. In amenorrhea, secondary 6 characters present and not present, then thin girl, obese girl, and normal build girl. In excessive bleeding, we have seen the menorrhagia, problem in the uterus, polymenorrhea, problem in the ovaries, polymenorrhagia, problem in pelvic region, that is PID, and metrorrhagia, surface lesion will be there. In the dysmenorrhea, 3 types. First is a primary or the normal dysmenorrhea, then second is a congestive, and third was the endometriosis. We are going to talk about all these cases with Ayurvedic perspective or Ayurvedic management in the next lecture. So thank you very much for your patience hearing. I wish you all the best and I request all of you to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much.